guys. I'm driving, as you can see. Alright, so today I'm taking you guys along with me again. I have a speaking engagement at Oriental Hotel. It's quite a nice hotel. It's for an organisation called Women and Ladies in Business. I'm one of the guest speakers today. So it's going to be an interesting day. I've not done one of these in a while. I'm not sure what sort of numbers I'll be speaking to, but I guess we'll soon find out because I'm on my way there now. So yeah, guys, come along and have a little insight. You guys already have an insight to my world, but my speaking world. Yeah, let's go, guys. My hair is laid. Chai. We're ready. Let's go. Let's go and talk. Tell everybody about entrepreneurship. So I did red carpet. And when you're doing red carpet, you can't film yourself. You guys missed that part.
To connect with what I see. So I came here and I was in awe of you guys. I saw the women in the markets with the children on their back, selling the market. Traffic going past them, sitting by the gutter, but yet they're making a living. They have nothing, as far as I'm concerned, from where I was standing. This is nothing, or this is what I was told is nothing, but yet you have so much. So I think that's an incredible, incredible thing, and I really just urge you ladies to tap into that natural, God-given passion and resilience that Nigerians have. And I pray to God that I can also gain from it, because I'm learning every day from them. I'm gaining so much from you guys. So that's, for me, the root of entrepreneurship. Dig into that which comes natural. Don't take it for granted one bit, because entrepreneurship comes from survival. You have to be hungry. You have to be incredibly hungry. And the fact that you're all sitting here tells me that you're hungry. Let's all be hungry together, because I'm very hungry. Very, very hungry for what we can do, and what we can do as women. And I always say to my team, that, you know, I have a team full of men. Majority of the people on my team are men, and some of them are here today. But I have some women in my team as well, and I'm always looking to grow my female team. I'm in a male-dominated industry, it goes without saying. But tomorrow, I'd like to see more women. I like to grow that, because in the time and age in which we're in right now, women, we're incredible. Yeah. If you go back in time and still your mark, you're incredible. You are special. And that's a true entrepreneur to me, personally. Someone who can make something out of nothing. So as far as I'm concerned, I'm surrounded by entrepreneurs in here already. The fact that you decided to come to this event means that you are hungry. And I hope that all of us, as we have this conversation today, are able to feed that hunger and we learn from you and vice versa. So I look forward to some of your questions. So thank you very much for having me.
Well, how do you get the word out there, especially when you're on low budget? You don't want to necessarily spend all the money you have on
by yourself. All it is, you're paying for their time. Because the skill set is very much there. You go on Facebook, you pick three top social media platforms. Don't do all of them, just overstretching yourself. Pick your top three. For me, it's YouTube, Instagram, Facebook. Those three. And say to yourself, I'm going to set myself 1 hour to start off with, don't overwork it. 1 hour on a Wednesday afternoon for me to post these things online. You sit there, you shut your door, you tell all your distractions to leave you for 1 hour. You post those things, you hashtag it, you send it to friends and family. Those are the only ones you can do for now at the beginning. And you encourage them to also share it. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's not going to be like magic. You have to work it. A lot of people go on social media and think, oh, social media, just post all of a sudden, I have a million followers. No. It doesn't happen. You have to do it on a consistent basis. And most people will tell you, when they start to post on social media, one person liked, two people commented in a month. Nobody paid attention. And all of a sudden, you see that person that's blown on social media. Now, wow, they don't do it for 8 years or the same thing for 8 years until somebody caught on to it. So don't throw your money, like she also mentioned, you can use a little bit of budget and do sponsored ads on Instagram. Instagram right now is the bomb diggity. Yeah. Take 10,000 Naira, maybe even 5,000 Naira, post something on social media, choose your demographic and let it just work for you. The investment will pay up in the long run. Do you understand? So start off small, but most importantly, be consistent and only choose three. Don't spread yourself too thin.
You know how to sell this person, but you're hot somehow. So it's better you draw the lines very, very clear and say, okay, Brussels, see, for every job that comes, if I'm providing this or if I'm providing this, this is the amount. I mean, it's a stated plan. You know, this particular model works a lot in our industry. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
The writing it down part got everybody.
Yes.
We all agree, don't we?
We are all in burnt. you wanted to add something to it.
I just wanted to ask the young man, How often do you get proposals for Lagos? Is it Lagos or Abuja?
Abuja. You mentioned Abuja, yeah? So how often do you get calls or prospects?
Inquiries, prospects.
Most times I see the request online, on either on Twitter. So it's almost every day.
Every day.
Yeah.
How many requests are you getting from your town where you're based at the moment?
Few.
Okay, I'm trying to move on. I don't understand. The time has reached for you to pack your load and go where your fruit is growing.
Your ministry needs to move.
You need to move. Go to the promised land. If it is Abuja, if it is Lagos, if your own land is dry, it's time for you to consider time to move. Take a trip, book a ticket, go to Abuja, go on prospects. Go to where your clients are. I always say to people here, what do you do? What's your line of business?
The design branding strategy. The design branding strategy and events management.
You're losing money, guys. I'm talking. You're losing money. It's time for you to pack your bags, go to where your prospects are, and sit there for a good 2 weeks and do some feasibility studies. What I did in Lagos. When somebody said to me, "My dear, your furniture is wonderful, and I think people in Nigeria will really enjoy your stuff," I packed my bags, I've never lived here, I came here and I said, you know what, I'm going to stay here for a month and do feasibility studies. When I saw my client to my right, my client to my left, and I saw the market, I said, hey, mommy, daddy, see you later, I'm moving to Lagos, here I am. You have to do exactly the same thing. Have belief in what you're doing. Go out there, go find your clients. Why are you sitting in your own town? There's no business there for you. You can't be honest with you.